Welcome back to Let's Code. Today we are talking about fancy error handling in Rust. On the left-hand side here, we have the gradient, the random gradient or random color generating CLI that we built in a previous episode. And I've left up here an example of it running into an error, basically. Like the input that the user gave it to generate a gradient was incorrect input, and thus we have to report to the user that their input was in fact incorrect and help them figure out how to change it. So there's a number of things we can notice here. First of all, is that this does still work if we give it the right number of stops and the right number of colors. But as soon as we take away the correct number of stops, it doesn't match the number of colors anymore. We get this wonderful error output. Now, this output is powered by miette, M-I-E-T-T-E. We have the fancy features enabled because we want, you know, all the beautiful colors and everything. And we can see we get a number of things here. So right here at the top, this is what the usage of our CLI will look like with a couple of dash C flags and a couple of dash S flags. The first thing that is reported out is an error code. So this is our library is called gencolor, and the error code is colors and steps mismatch. So we could use this as an ID somewhere, say, on docs.rs or in a GitHub repo somewhere to point people to a more thorough explanation of the error that's happening. In this case, it's not that complicated, so we don't have that. Then we have what we'll call an error chain, or like additional context for the error. When we were generating a gradient, the number of colors and the number of steps must match. And then we've got this little piece of code here that looks like source code or something like that. In this case, we are pointing to these three values and calling them the colors, and these two values and calling them the stops. And we've got some little help text down here that says, match the number of colors 3 with the number of stops 2. So if we look back at the source code, so to speak here, we've got 3 colors and 2 stops, and you know, maybe we could just add one more stop. So building out really useful errors takes a bit more effort than I've put in here. This is just an example of what you can do with miette and what you can do with the fancy error reporting. There are actually 3 different, almost equally applicable libraries for error reporting. One of them is anyhow. One of them is color error. That's E-Y-R-E. And the other one is miette, the one we're exploring today. They all have fairly similar features. So if you haven't used any of them, that's totally fine. So we'll start in our main.rs file. We've changed the return type of our main function to return a result. This result comes from miette, and it is the type that is used for handling the error reporting for miette. If we scroll down, we can see that in our commands random, which is entirely encapsulated inside of this one file, we are now returning an OK type with a unit value if we have successfully executed a command. Same thing for the gradient generate function, except in the gradient generate function, we're now returning a result with a specific error type that we've now created, which means that here we're getting back a result type with that error that we've created. And miette allows us to wrap that error in additional context. So when we see when generating gradient here, that comes from this text right here. So any error that happens inside of gradient generate will get wrapped in this when generating gradient context. So that leaves us with the generate function itself, which returns our error, and the definition of our error, which is in lib.rs. At its core, our custom error, the one that we use in our library, is just a regular enum that we use this error to derive error for. So you can think of this error as a way to define new error types in Rust easily, and miette as a way to report those errors in a way that is visually pleasing for the user. So we've named our kind of like entire project's error type color generation error. I've left in here an IO error just to prove that we can have multiple errors, but we otherwise are only implementing one error. So if we wrote these gradient values, like the successful gradient colors out to a file, we could use this IO error, color generation error, :, IO error. But we'll focus on the colors and steps must match error. So this is a variant inside of the color generation error enum. Miette in combination with this error allow us to define the error macro, so number of colors and number of steps must match, which is what gets reported right here. So this is what we say is our error chain, right? Inside of the gradient generation function, there was an error that was the colors and steps must match error. So we've got that chain going down into our functions. I mean, this could be as deep as we want it to be. We also include a diagnostic, that is the gen color, colors and steps, mismatch error code. So right at the top here, that's the first thing that's printed, sort of a unique identifier for this error and what it represents, something that we can use to generate URLs so that we can have deeper explanations of the errors in our libraries. The colors and steps must match variant has a field for the source code. Now, we don't have source code. We have the input from our CLI. So we'll stringify that in a certain way because technically we don't need like a source code file. We can just use any string we want here. Then we've got a field for the help text. So we use the help attribute macro, and that will let us create a format string here to suggest an action to the user so that they can actually do something to fix the error. The Rust compiler is really good about these errors or these help texts being very useful and actionable. So it's a nice feature to have. And then we've got two labels here, and that's the purple colors here and the yellow stops. So what happens is the label is the text that shows up here, while the tuple here is a source span, or something that can get turned into a source span. In this case, is a tuple from the starting location to the ending location in the source file. And this variant will output this wonderful error output for us, but we still have to use it. So inside of our generate function, we'll change it to return either unit if it's successful or our color generation error. So it's important to note that this result is the result type in Rust. It's nothing special. While the result in main is the result type from miette specifically. So here in our library code, all we're doing is returning the error that we are constructing. The error here happens fairly quickly, actually, which is really good for us because it makes this a little bit more quick to the point. So if the colors.length is greater than 0 and the colors.length is not equal to the stops or the number of stops that we have, then we return this error. And of course, we've got the input, whatever source code we want to put here. We've got the advice, which is match number of colors, whatever, with number of stops, whatever. And then we pass in the colors.length and the stops.length. And that's this help text right here. So it gets passed through for us because we've defined this advice field as being the help text. And we get to make that whatever we want when we construct this error. The input text is going to be the color input, the number of steps, and the stops. So for us, those come from gradient options. We probably could instead implement something on gradient options, like the source trait, for example, but I chose not to do that. I chose to just pass in a string manually. I find that for this example, it's a bit more clear. We pulled out the colors as a debug string and the stops as a debug string so that we can get this vec output here. So we've got an array of values and an array of values. We also pull these numbers out, or we pull these strings out so that we can calculate the offsets. So this input string is of some length, right? And if we want this line to be as long as this text, we have to know how long that text is. So when we set color source, we start at 0 because it starts at the beginning of the file, and we go to the length of the color string. So that's our color debug output. And then for stops, we do the color string length plus 4 because, let's see, new line and then two values here, and then new line starts us on line 3. And then we draw a line that is the stops length. So that's how we get a line that covers exactly this length for the stops. And that's it. Whenever we hit the error, instead of panicking here, which is what we were doing before, we're returning an error, our error, inside of the error variant for the result. So if we hit this logic, we return that error in main. That means this generate function will return an error. It will get wrapped here, and it will get returned from the match, from the main function, and miette will take all of that information that we've defined with the additional context that we've given with these attribute macros to tell it how to display that context, and it will display all of that context for us right here when the user uses our library or CLI or whatever it is. So this is kind of something that might feel a little bit more unfamiliar if you're not used to using libraries like Anyhow or Color Error. But it's a really nice way of displaying errors when something goes wrong, and doing so consistently and doing so with a whole bunch of additional context that can actually help the user diagnose what went wrong and then actually fix it. So I hope if you have been exposed to miette for the first time today that you enjoyed the video, and I will catch you in the next video. Have a great day.